Damn, these is pretty. These are so pretty. Look.
Finally, I can be saved. Light outside, but it seems they bit a part of me in my dreams.
So, let's get into everything that we got and what we about to use. So, first things first is you want to have your flowers. I got these off of Amazon. These are fake flowers. These are not real. So, they're going to be linked in my Amazon storefront. You already know it. It came in a pack of like 10 or 11 or something like that. The next thing is you want to get like wrapping paper. But you want to get like this. It's specific for wrapping flowers, like the material of it, like you want to make sure it's this specific material. And I got those off Amazon too. Then I got this tacky spray. I got this from Michaels. You can really use any type of adhesive spray, it doesn't matter, it just needs to be adhesive spray. And then I also got this purple glitter. Does it have a specific color? I don't see the actual color on here. So I got this. This is also from Michaels too. And then the last thing you need is just some tape. So I think it would be better if you use clear tape, but your girl don't got no clear tape. And I'm not getting ready to do all of that for this bouquet. Again, this bouquet is for pictures. That's it. So the first thing that I did was start with the like wrapping paper to make sure that was all good to go. So I'm going to show you guys exactly how I did it. So the first thing you want to do is start off by folding it over. And the big deal is to make sure that the two triangles on the sides are kind of like even. Just, they don't have to be perfect, but you want to get them to as close to like the same size as possible. Then you're just going to fold the paper over from there, and you're going to like align those triangles. Again, you want them to all kind of be like the same size, so it doesn't look like weird once, you know, all of them are together. So then you'll flip it over and you'll just kind of like secure those in pieces, and then like any other pieces that are kind of like flopping around. And you can again just do that with any kind of tape. You just want to make sure that once you start to wrap these pieces of paper like around your flowers, you want to make sure they're not gonna unravel. So I'll repeat the steps just a few more times just so you guys can kind of see how, you know, how it'll look. So after that, I doubled up two plastic bags to put the glitter in just to make sure that none of the glitter fell out. And then I took another plastic bag so that I could lean the roses over it and spray the glue on just to make sure, you know, that the glue doesn't fly all over and gets all over my table and my floors and all that good stuff. So you're just going to spray over the entire rose, or just as much as, you know, wherever you want the glitter to be at. I want the glitter to cover up a lot of the rose. I don't really want too much peeking through, so I just coated it very good with the tacky glue, and then I just dip it into the plastic bag and kind of just kind of like flop it around. And then after that, you just kind of want to tap it to get all of that excess glitter off, and then you just kind of will set it to the side to let it dry. So I'll do this process also again, and look at that, that just looks so pretty. So again, I'll do this over again just so you guys can kind of see. Alright, so now I'm getting ready to arrange them so I can get ready to wrap the wrapping paper around. They smell toxic, but they're gorgeous, okay? Let's give a round of applause to these beauties. Like, are you kidding me?
Whew, baby. Baby. Yeah.
Okay, so now I'm just arranging them in a way that, you know, they kind of form a circular shape. You want to make sure while you're doing this that you're like constantly turning the bouquet, because if you don't, like, you'll look at one angle and it'll look like it's in a circle, but then like you'll look at a different angle later on and it won't be. So you just want to make sure that you're constantly twisting it to make it be like in a circular shape. And then after, once you get it all settled and it looks good, you want to just tie them together. I really just use a scrunchie, but you know, you can use rubber bands or, you know, anything like that. And then you're gonna start to wrap those pieces of paper around it, and you just want to make sure that they're all even, like there's none that are like shorter than the others. So you just want to make sure that they're all at the same height. And then after you do that, you're just gonna secure them all with tape.
Okay, so I got most of the paper like secured. The main thing right now is I just want to get this bottom as secure as possible, because we don't want this shit coming apart and embarrassing us while we out to eat or anything like that. So we gonna really make sure this shit is nice and secure with this tape. All right, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take this black ribbon and I'm gonna wrap it around this part nice and neat, and then I'm just gonna make a bow and then tape that bow on top, well, glue it on top. So I'm gonna just go ahead, I don't need much of this ribbon, to just kind of go around it one time. Got my glue gun. So I got my glue gun. This ribbon is from Michael's. So I don't want to have any of this tape kind of like peeking up through, and whatever it is, I'm just gonna cut off. So now that should be good for me to wrap it around. So I'm gonna go ahead and secure this first. I'm gonna secure it with tape. I don't wanna waste the glue. So I'm gonna secure it with tape. And more than likely, like at all times, my hands are gonna be covering up this part. Put a little bit of glue right here just to make that shit be still. And we just actually gonna cut some of this extra off, because they're playing games with us. Take this little bit of glue, put that right along that little side. Careful, y'all, because hot glue do not give any fucks about you or your fingers. So now I'm getting ready to just try my best to make a bow. I haven't made a bow in a very long time, so hopefully this works out. So let's do one, two, and then we're gonna do one, two, big thing, because I want a nice size bow. And then boom, make sure that's straight. Okay, and then once you have that, let's cut down here, hopefully that's enough. And then you go through here, gonna put it through that little spot. Okay. And then I'm gonna pull that nice and tight right in the center here. So right in the center. And then you're just gonna keep gonna keep going over. Pull these apart, and then you're gonna do the same thing here. Pull these apart, It's other ways that you can make, but so you can look them up if you want a different bow. But now that I have this bow and it's good to go, all I'm gonna do is secure this bow on the where you can see the slit in my bouquet, because I don't want that to be able to easily be seen. A little bit of hot glue. I'm just gonna put it all nice and thick right on the center there. And then, oh yeah. So I'm just gonna hold that on there, let that dry off, and then I'm gonna show y'all everything once it's done. All right, y'all, so my bouquet is done now. My bow is glued on here and secure, and then this, whew, y'all, this is beautiful. So I'll have to clean off the excess glitter before I actually take any pictures. But yeah, like this bad boy is so gorgeous, y'all. I can't get behind how gorgeous this was. And in total, this cost me roughly about $50 to $60, basically. I'm gonna be so pretty.